Heludduni to Kedaya, Bisodaya, Protmilo Damudaya, Chamma Shastro Vibodaya, Rasodaya Chittar Pitanamodaya, Shashad Bhakti Vinodaya Samodaya, Madurja Marjadaya, Sri Chaitanya Daya Nidhe Tavadaya, Bhuyadamandadaya, Sri Chaitanya Daya Nidhe Tavadaya, Bhuyadamandadaya. Gauriya Goshtipati, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta, Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, in the history of human civilization, Gauriya Goshtipati, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta, Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, in the history of human civilization, nobody could expect that this kind of gift can come in the life of, you know, in this material world. Nobody could expect this kind of, you know, gift can come in our life. That's why it's an exclusive thing. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada speaking, if you are following pure Guru Vaishnava, then you can understand what kind of excellent gift waiting for you. What to speak about expecting? They cannot even in dream, they cannot think. This kind of gift, whole human society can get very easily by the mercy of Rupanuga Guru Varga. Day by day, I like to explain this excellency. But actually, the sloka I started with is very excellent sloka. It is speaking by Sarup Damodarji. Actually, Sarup Damodarji is a Navadip Leela Parshad. Previously his name was Purushottam Brahmachari. Purushottam Brahmachari in Navadip Leela. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took sannyas, he just couldn't bear this separation. He was bound to run like crazy. Where to go? He ran just at Varanasi. Somehow he was bound to take sannyas. And his name was Sarup. Damodar actually his title. Damodar actually his title. He is versed in Sangeet. In Sangeet Vidya, singing. He was big master. Sangeet Damodar, one book he wrote also, about how to sing, what is the procedure, big. That's why his title was given Damodar. He was very excellent singer, master of all singer. That's why he was given this title actually Damodar. Now the sloka I started with is, you know, spoken by Sarup Damodarji. He couldn't bear the separation of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu anyway. He was bound to run here and there, ultimately reach Varanasi. He couldn't bear just. And after that took sannyas. And then still it was impossible for him to stay there. Ultimately he came here when heard Mahaprabhu already in Purushottam Dham, Nilacham. He came and paid prostrated obeisances unto the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as if he is going to throw himself as a nice flower unto the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. As if he wanted to throw himself as a nice flower unto the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as Puspanjali. Then and there, in front of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he was bound to speak this thing. Helodduni to khedaya visodaya pratmilo damudaya Shamma Sastro Vibodaya Rasodaya Chittra Pitanamodaya Shashad Bhakti Vinodaya Samodaya Madhurja Marjadaya He Chaitanya Daya Nidhetavadaya Bhuyad Amandadaya Bhuyad Amandadaya Daya. Actually, Sarvdamadhar wanted to say this kind of kindness was never shown in world history. This kind of kindness, actually daya and karuna almost same. Dayo actually Sanskrit, there is root, dhatu. Dayo dhatu is very soft. One to fulfill the desire of somebody who is having some deficiency. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada speaking, to be frank, we are all beggar. To be frank, we are all beggar of daya. Some or other way, we are always begging something. Always we are beggar. Give me some education. I don't have any education. I don't know English. Give me some education. Give me some Sanskrit knowledge, mathematics knowledge. This is all the time we are begging something, material thing. That's why Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, to be frank, we are all beggar. We want to beg something, sometime property, money, property, designation, so many things, honor, respect, always begging, give. Or directly or indirectly. This is our life, nakedness. Our nakedness can never be stopped because it is our habit. Our nakedness can never be stopped because it is our habit. What to speak? You know, some kind of people there, they have enough money, enough property, enough business. Still here they are running to get more and more. No limit of expectation. They cannot put any limit. Expectation going on and on, up. That's why no question of fulfillment. Jive Sarupai Krishna Nitya Das is very important thing, very preliminary thing, but it's very most important thing. Very, I know it's very preliminary thing, everybody knows, but not knowing from heart. Philosophically they are knowing, they can memory, Jive Swarupai Krishna Nitya Das. If they can discover this in a Saru, then no question of any problem. All problem can be stopped. Now Prabhupada speaking, anyway we are beggar. Some other way we all are beggar. We are always expecting something from somebody. And who can show us kindness, those who are having their certain platform? One beggar cannot beg some money from another beggar. But those true. Another beggar means, in deeply if you think, he is beggar. He is owning, he is having billions of dollars. He is also beggar, big beggar. And another street beggar begging some money from him. Both of them beggar. Maybe some difference is there in the outlook, but they are all beggar. Until and unless we can understand our sarup, what to beg from Sadhu Guru Vaishnava, still their problem can persist in our life, whole life. Persist, can stay continuously. Persist in our life. Permanently. Nobody can solve. Why you are coming in front of Guru Vaishnava? To solve this problem. To solve this problem. Solve this problem means to know our sarup, to get some such property so that our nakedness can stop or whatever. We can feel we are property. What Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to speak? Prem dhan vina bertho daridra jivan das kori betan mare deho prem dhan. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to speak, I am actually a beggar, I want to get Premdhan. Without Premdhan, the life of, our life is all empty. Without Premdhan, how to get, what is the procedure, what was Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came in this material world, what was the secret procedure, what is the inner meaning of that sloka, you know, Radha Krishna, Milita Tanuji is this sloka. So, day by day we will have to discuss. Krishna Varnam Tisha Krishnam also, very secrecy. Not that only one word we can say, the meaning is over. This Krishna Varnam Tisha Krishnam Sangha Bhanga Sparsadam, if time permit, today I like to discuss because from tomorrow, so very secret philosophy will have to discuss, actually. So, Sarup Damodar, what Sarup Damodar wanted to speak by this sloka, is very important sloka. Sarup Damodar is speaking, your kindness, your daya is so great that it easily, if there is any dust particle covering our sarup, it can easily be erased. Helo tuni to khe daya. Any kind of disarray is khed, khedaya. Khed means Sanskrit word. Khed means dissatisfaction. Khed means dissatisfaction. We are always repenting. Oh, I don't have education much. I am not going to foreign country. I have no disciple. I have no money, position. This way, khed is called khed. We are always repenting. See, Sarup Damodar wanted to speak. This kind of dissatisfaction can vanish from your life. Helo dunito khedaya visudaya prathmilo damodaya. Actually, your mercy, your kindness can never be compared with any object. Never, with anything. And actually point is there, helo dunito khedaya visudaya prathmilo damodaya samma shastra vibodaya rasodaya chittar pitan modaya. Any kind of altercation, hey, you are wrong, your judgment is not good, your siddhanta is wrong, your siddhanta wrong, no, I am right, you are wrong, this kind of fighting can vanish. If you can have a nice glance onto the lotus feet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, after looking, you can lose everything, all patience. You can lose and throw yourself onto the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. It is not a question of philosophy, it is a question of direct feeling. That's why Prabhupada Saraswati Bhat told, prasarita prema piyusa rasa sagare jo vanchito sa vanchito vanchito smisa. There is flood of prema all over the world, inundated. But if I cannot get, then it's a question of high, you know, degradation. Big. Why I am not getting? Prasarita prema piyusha rasa maha rasa sagare jo vanchito vanchito sisa. He is vanchito. Actually, point is that any kind of fighting between pandit, sadhu, fighting can stop. Whenever you have the chance to look at the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that's why Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami was bound to speak, Si Chaitanya Padam Bhujo Madhupe Bhyo Namo Namaha, Si Chaitanya Padam Bhujo Madhupe Bhyo Namo Namaha, Kathanchit Asrayat Jesam Sao Pitat Kanda Bhag Bhavet. Actually, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is bound to speak this thing, that all the honeybees, they are hovering around the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Si Chaitanya Padam Bhujo Madhupe Bhyo Namo Namaha. Those who are hovering around the lotus feet, lotus flower-like feet. of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They like to get, what is the target? They like to get some honey. When you can find all those honeybees, they have the chance to sit in the core of flower, have the chance to suck honey, then all boom, this kind of sign stop. Follow. No more sound. When they start getting honey, then no sound. But before that, when they're roaming around, there is sound. Boom, there's sound. When they sit and start taking honey, sucking honey, then all problem finish. All, you know, no sound there. Sri Chaitanya Padambhaja Madhupe Bhyo Namo Namaha. Madhupe Bhyo Namo Namaha. Madhupe Bindoja. Honeybees, those were roaming around, hovering around the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, lotus feet. Kathanchit Asrayat Jesha. If you have the take the shelter of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu a little bit, Kathanchit. Kathanchit means not fully. Maybe you are not surrendered 100%. Kathanchit Asrayat Jesam. A little bit, if you have the chance to take shelter of such honeybee, such one honeybee, like our Guru Varga Prabhupada Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Kathanchit Asrayat Jesam, Swaupi Tat Gandhabhag Bhavit. Such honeybee is there. If you have the chance to take shelter of such honeybees, a little bit, then you can also get the nice smell, fragments coming out. You know, sandajyo, saukarjo, you know, nice smell coming out of lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. You can get, you can feel some sort of intoxication. No more fighting. If there is no material thinking, if your heart is totally off from this material world, then there is no problem. If your heart is totally off from this material world, then what problem? Gopikas, they are speaking same thing. Gopikas in Kurukshetra speaking same thing. Those who have no attraction for family life, what kind of bondage can be there? Saṃsāra asakti nahi jāya deho bandhan. Where from this kind of bondage can come? This is the problem. So actually, any kind of fighting between two pandits, between sadhus, you know, they are fighting about siddhanta, about anything, any, that can be stopped. Rasodaya, raso udaya. I was given very small time, very short time there. I wanted to speak this secrecy about Bhagavat, first canto, first sloka. Yanma dasu yato anmayadita raschata savigya sarat tene brahma idayo adikavayamo yhanti. This sloka, here the first word is that. First word, what? First, Bhagavat, first canto, first sloka, Yanmadasyo. Yanmadasyo means Yanmu Adi Asyo, Yanmu Adi Asyo, Kasyo Vishasyo. I mean, Yanmu Adi Kasyo Vishasyo Yatoho. Yatoho means by Supreme Lord. Je, follow. Janmo adi, janmo sthiti bhangur. Janmo means creation of this material world and maintenance and destruction, total. All done by the Supreme Divinity, Supreme Lord, Bhagavan Sri Krishna. Janma dasu yato. Anmayad itaratastra. Itarata mane directly or indirectly. All done by Supreme Lord. But you cannot see Him as a focus. You cannot see. He is always background, backside. You cannot see him, discover him. I was speaking about this sloka. If this sloka, if I can make the meaning of this sloka this way, Yanmadasya yato, if I cannot, I can also get this kind of meaning. But if I can speak, Janmo adyasya yato ho. Janmo adyasya na. Same thing. In Sandhi, if you break, you can add. Krishna Varnam Tisha Krishna also, I can make Jagladi, a Sanskrit grammar. One splitter, again add, again split, you can get different kind of meaning. Follow. Janmo adyasya yato ho. Adyasya means Adi rasasya. Janmo adyasya yataho. Janmo adyasya yataho means Adi rasasya. Adi ras means primeness. Finally, is called madurasa. Oh, more filtered way, parakya madurasa. Yataho. If I can make this kind of meaning, this nice meaning can come. I was also wanted to speak, explain this thing. Raghupati Upadhyay. Raghupati Upadhyay, one big Pandit and Brahman, very nice Vaishnav, who came to meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Allahabad Arail Gram, one village named Arail. There Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was invited by whom? Balvacharya ji. That time he was at home. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went there and Raghupati Upadhyay came to meet him. There was nice discourse between this Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Raghupati Upadhyay. Mahaprabhu knowing or heard of Raghupati Upadhyay, Mahaprabhu wanted to put question. Among all Dhamma, which one is topmost? Bara, Mathupuri, Madhupuri, Bara. Bara mean tough. Bara mean tough. Baradar Sabha, I told you, no? Baradar Sabha, Rishabha, Rishabha mean Sesto. And Bara mean Rupanugavara. We say, no? He is Rupanugavara. Bara means Sesto. So, Bara, Mathupuri, Madhupuri, Bara. Among all Dhamma, Madhupuri, Mathura is topmost. And because why? Mathura is the topmost place. Mathura means including Vrindavan. Mathura, city you can say, but Mathura means inside that Vrindavan is there. So, Bara, Madhupuri, Bara is topmost, is the home land of Krishna himself, where he is playing all the time, different kind of pastime going on, all exchanging different kind of five rasa. This kind of five rasa, excellent rasa, you cannot expect in excellent way, pure way. Though whole world going to enjoy rasa, whole infinity world going to enjoy rasa. Because without rasa, who is going to live? You like to live? Without rasa? No. Nobody, not even, you know, lizard, cockroach, snake, you know, everybody, who not? Even pig is taking nice stool daily. Very nice. Today, big my big fist, I get nice stool today. Aha. Yes, is also. We are also. Today's sweet ball, Malpua, feast, big feast, Jagannath, there in Puri, big feast. They pull me to take this rasa. I was bound to go there, take rasa. Nice Jagannath prasadam rasa, I took. So all the time we are running for rasa. Material rasa is dangerous. But anyway, without rasa, no jivatma like to live. Without rasa. So directly or indirectly all rasa coming from that Supreme Lord. But I can try to prove what is the excellency with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. What is the shortage with Krishna? There is There cannot be any shortage, but still shortage. I like to speak day by day. So without rasa, nobody likes to live. Directly or indirectly, actually rasa is maintaining the whole world. Family life we are leading, different kind of relation, different kinds of, we are always rasa. That's why Upanishad we find raso vaisha. Raso vaisha, definitely, no, it was say he is the source of rasa. Raso vaisha. Raso evahi ayam. Labdhanandi bhavati. From him, jiva getting different kind of rasa. Directly, indirectly. And so they like to live more and more enjoying their life. Directly or indirectly, all rasa there. Getting from the source, main source, rasa vaisha. Now, actually point is that, without rasa, we don't like to live. So, but indirect rasa means material rasa is very dangerous. Material rasa always can put us in trouble, bondage. But aprakrita rasa we need. That Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to give through Harinam Sankirtan. I like to discuss this point first, background, actually. So, actually, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to give us the taste of Harinam first. Taste of Harinam. If you can get this taste, you cannot leave Harinam. You cannot leave Harinam. You can know very well that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to Varanasi. There, Prakasananda Saraswati putting question, why you are doing dancing and chanting, loudly singing, why? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to give them answer, why you don't come here to hear Vedanta from us? What is the reason? Maybe, why you are not coming here to hear Vedanta from us? Mahaprabhu told, my Gurudev told me that you are foolish number one. You are murka. So you have no right in Vedanta. So you can go on chanting this Harinam. You can go on chanting this Harinam. So by the mercy of Guru, instruction of Gurudev, now I am doing chanting Harinam. I don't know how I become crazy. I don't know why. How? Mahaprabhu told, Kiba manto dila gosai kiba tar fall, jopite jopite manto karilo pagal. Hasi kadi nahi ami apon ichhai. I am not singing, dancing, crying. I am not doing purposely. Automatically I become mad. I am dancing and chanting. So this is the condition. But to speak more, now I like to go back to the point what Raghupati Upadhyay wanted to speak in front of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Raghupati Upadhyay Mahaprabhu asking, which dhamma is topmost, you think? Bada Mathipuri Madhupuri Vara. And what age of Krishna is topmost? I mean, excellent. Actually, Sam Eva Param Rupam. Shyam eva param rupam. Shyam rup, Shyam Sundari is topmost, Shyam eva param rupam, Paramathuburi bara. And Addo eva paravarasaha. Addo eva paravarasaha. Shyam eva param rupam. And Addo eva paravarasaha. Addo ras, I mean, the Madhuras at topmost. That is that also Param Vijayata Sri Krishna Sankirtanam. Why it is the slogan of Gauriamat? Why it is the slogan of Gauriamat? Param Vijayata Sri Krishna Sankirtanam. Why? It is the slogan of Gauriamat because from this slogan you can find excellent rasas are coming. Param Vijayata Sri Krishna Sankirtanam. Param Vijayata. Topmost. Param Vijayata Sri Krishna Sankirtanam, from this Krishna Sankirtanam is the slogan of Gaudiya Math, because through Sankirtan we can get everything day by day. So Addo Eva Pararasaha or Janma Addasya Yatoho. So all same. Wanted to. That is the gift of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. I can come gradually. But first of all, it was the Siddhanta of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to establish this thing. Through Sankirtan, you can get everything. You can clear your heart. You can get all everything through Sankirtan. Naam Sankirtana Paive Sakal. Naam Sankirtana, through Naam Sankirtan, you can get everything. Through Naam Sankirtan. Sarup Gosai, I was speaking about the sloka Helad Dunita Khedaya Visudaya. That Sarup Gosai was the topmost authority of Gauriya Sampradaya. Sarup Gosai was the topmost, still today. Sarup Gosai is the topmost authority of Gauriya Sampradaya. Who make him topmost authority of Gauriya? Who make? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu make him. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself makes Sarup Gosai the topmost authority of this Gauriya Sampradaya. How you know? How we know? Where is the document? Maybe you can remember, I told you. Well, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to manifest this kind of Leela, Gundicha Manjan. Gundicha, through Gundicha Manjan, Mahaprabhu wanted to prove Chaitadarpana Marjana Sloka in applied form. At the same time, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to show that Sarup Gosai is the topmost authority. And this is the practical procedure. Also, I like to touch Vedanta Sutta, through which I can prove what is the excellency of transcendental sound vibration. First, scientific way. So actually, Gundicha Munji Marjan, this Leela was manifested by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you can remember. There one thing is very important, you can remember, that it was the order of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu not to speak any material word. Everybody is speaking code language. Hare Krishna! Hare Krishna! This way, always. Nobody is speaking any material sound, because material sound, directly or indirectly, if we are using extensively, all the time material, so we are in bondage. It seems I am speaking Harikatha, but who can say I am not speaking material katha? Because transcendental sound vibration coming out of the transcendental heart. Material people, they cannot utter transcendental sound vibration. Not possible. Scientific procedure. One material person cannot sing the glories of Krishna perfectly. Maybe it is one kind of dry philosophy. He can memorize, or he can put mobile in front of him, sloka, or in paper he can write, he can read and speak in front of public, or his memory is nice. I have seen that day also, one brahmachari looking mobile and paper and quoting nice sloka. I have seen, are you sitting? Actually, this kind of, you know, dry philosophy cannot touch your heart. So actually, transcendental sound, Aprakrita Shabda and Prakrita Shabda is very important. It's very important actually. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when Gundicha Manjir Manjan going on, then Mahaprabhu gave instruction everybody should speak in gesture, this way. Everybody is doing so. In between, one Brahmin, very nice heart, he is coming in front of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. One kalsi, I mean pitcher, full of water from Indradumna Sarovar. They are all carrying thousands of mud pot. And one pot is straightway coming in front of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, putting all water in the unto the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu manifesting Bhakta Leela, he become very angry. Why you put water there, in front of this Prabhu? Prabhu Singhasan is there, it's in the temple. Why you put water? He calls Sarup Goswami, Sarup, come here. What happens, Prabhu? You come, you see. There is activities in. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu straight away speaking to Sarup Goswami, Tomar Gauriya kare etek phayyati. Tomar Gauriya. If you learn Bengali, you can understand. Your Gauriya, you see, he is doing this kind of, you know, erasity, making problem. Your Gauriya. Tomar Gauriya kare etek phayyati. He is making all joking, eh? He is putting water here in front of in this temple inside. This way we know indication that Sarup Goswami was made the authority, topmost authority of, you know, Gauriya Sampradaya. Rupa Goswami Pa, Sanatan Goswami Pa, Raghunath Das Goswami, anybody there, Nitya Parsad, but still we are bound to say that it's all coming from Sarup Goswami. Very directly or indirectly, everything. So now actually point is that Heludduni to Khedaya Visudaya Prathmilo Damodaya. As Sammasastra Vibodaya Rasodaya Chittarpitan Modaya. Unmad, unmad means you can go mad. Chittarpitan Modaya. Rasodaya. Raso Udaya. So kind of, you know, fountain of rasa, unending, coming from your lotus feet. Nobody can check. Rasodaya. Chittarpitan Modaya. This kind of rasa can make us mad. We want to become mad. We want to become mad, no? We don't want to become mad? Then why you are coming in Gauriya Sampradaya? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was crying. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself, Krishna, and at the same time, Radharani is there. Tomorrow I can discuss. Very excellent. And through this sloka, I want to prove that Advai Gyan Tattva and Achinta Vedavet Tattva. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself is, you know, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu total embodiment of Achinta Vedavet Tattva. Tomorrow I can prove. Excellent. Achividinda Vedavet Tattva you can find in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu fully, balanced way. Now, actually, there is a source of rasa coming. Rasa Vaisa, I told you. And we can go mad when we can get this kind of rasa. We can go mad. Shashat Bhakti Vinodaya. Bhakti Vinod means, Bhakti mean action, Ovidev. Bhakti means serving Supreme Lord. Bhakti means to serve Supreme Lord. Prabhupada speaking, Bhakti means action. Bhakti is not dry philosophy, Bhakti. No, Bhakti means action. Bhakti can give you inspiration so that you are always trying to do something for Sadhu, Guru, Vaishnav, Dham, Nam, Parikar, for Krishna directly. All the time you feel it, you know, inspiration you are getting to do something, seva. It's called Shashat Bhakti Vinodaya. Instant, you can get the feeling, tremendous will. You cannot check yourself. We like to jump into seva. Shashat Bhakti Vinodaya, Samodaya, Madhurya Marjadaya. Madhurya Marjadaya. And Madhurya, I know Krishna is the source of all rasa, but I like to prove what Sarup Goswami told is 100% perfect. Na chaitanyat krishnat jagati paratattva paramyo. Sarup Goswami never told Krishna is the... Sarup Goswami told, na chaitanyat krishnat jagati paratattva paramyo. I mean, Krishna chaitanyat na jagati paratattva paramyo. Paratattva, extreme limit. Whenever I speak this word, extreme limit, you think there is limitation. Finite conception can't come. That is the main problem. Main problem is there, we material people, always when we speak this way, at the same time we think finite conception, because you are already speaking this way. You are speaking, no? Extreme limit? No! Extreme limit, I can use this word. But still, this extreme limit can be extended up to, extreme limit can be extended up to infinity. That I can prove. When Radharani coming in front of Krishna, actually first point is that Krishna is not Madan Mohan at all. Eh? Krishna is Madan Mohan, we know. Yes, you know. But Krishna is Madan Mohan when Radharani is there in front of Krishna. That you don't know. Hmm? When Radharani is there in front of Krishna, then Radharani, Krishna is Madan Mohan. Annatha, Vishwa Mohopi, Vishwa, he can hypnotize the whole world, but Swayam Madan Mohito. Radha Sangi Jada Bhati, Jada Radha Sangi Jada Bhati, Tadeva Madan Mohano. Tada Eva, affirmative. Radha Sangi Jada Bhati, Tadeva Madan Mohano, Annatha Vishwa Mohopi, Vishwa Mohopi. Swayam Madan Mohito. So, Saru Gosai wanted to give this evidence that we like to prove from tomorrow onward, that why Saru Gosai is speaking this way. Is Saru Gosai not speaking Krishna is the extreme limit? Saru Gosai said, no. Na Chaitanyat Krishnat Paratattva Paramiha. Extreme limit of Paratattva, we can see Radha Govinda Milita Tanu, see Gauranga, Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, no other than him. Why? That we like to prove from tomorrow. Na Chaitanyat Krishna Jagati Paratattva Paramiho. It's not possible. Paratattva, extreme limit. So, extreme limit, when I speak this word, that doesn't mean, extreme means some finite conception. That extreme limit can go on and on and on towards infinity level. I am not making any dry philosophy, it is written there. When Radharani come in front of Krishna, Krishna, his, you know, madhurya, affluent madhurya. In front of Sarup Gosai, Mahaprabhu wanted to speak, Sarup! In Allahabad. I want to give you just a test, just a test. Krishna is the infinity ocean of Madhurjo. Krishna is the infinity ocean of Madhurjo. One bonded soul, if get one, is going to get one drop that can inundate his whole life. I'm just going to give you a test. You open your mouth, I'd like to give you the test. Of Krishna Prema as the infinity ocean. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking this way. Infinity ocean of love, infinity ocean of beauty. Madhurya, infinity. So there is unending. So when Krishna coming in front of Radharani, Radharani coming in front of Krishna anyway, then the Madhurya of Krishna growing and watching the Madhurya of Krishna, getting the taste of Madhurya of Krishna, Radharani getting some sort of reaction. Also, by looking the reaction of Radharani, is Bivinna Bhava, excellent Bhava, Krishna also increases Madhurya. Again looking the extra Madhurya, excellent, Radharani expressing all different kind of rich. Again looking this Krishna, there is some competition going on. Yes, competition going on. Yes, it is written. I am not speaking. Krishna himself speaking, as if there is one kind of competition. I automatically, my Madhurya increasing. Radharani feels inspiration. He is exhibiting some to Baba. Also, I get inspiration to increase. This way, all competition going on. There is never any end of that. There is no limitation of that. I am very sorry. If you have any kind of limitation, I mean finite conception, first of all, it is the duty of Sadguru and Vaishnav to take you out of this material conception. First. Whereas Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself, Radha Govinda Milita Tanu, extreme point. Why Ramananda Rai go faint? What is the reason? A. Rai Ramananda is the eternal person of Mahaprabhu. Rai Ramananda is the eternal person of Krishna, Radharani. No? Visakasakhi. Why? What is the excellence he saw? He is habituated to see Krishna. We cannot expect Sarvabhauma Chaitanya can go faint, but why he has some excellency? Secrecy there. Why is Rai Ramananda go faint? Unconscious, fell unconscious. Then Mahaprabhu touch and gave. Tomorrow I can discuss this. Now actually point is that Mahaprabhu himself crying. Why Mahaprabhu crying? Mahaprabhu speaking, actually I have no prema for Krishna. Premdhan bina bertho darijyadhaman. I have no prema, I have no property, I am penniless. Mahaprabhu wanted to prove in front of us so that we can learn something. Whole life, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, every action of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu have multi-purpose. Each and every action by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has a multi-purpose. There's so many reasons. Why he is doing that? At the same time, he is going to do this thing. At the same time, he is going to do this thing. So many, multi-purpose. Not that one reason. Very excellent thing. Now, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is Supreme Lord. Actually, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to give us what? That we cannot feel. If we can feel, instant we can leave everything. Instant we can leave, throw everything. Go away. But we cannot feel. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took sannyas, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to exhibit some kind of sweet craziness. At that time, Sivananda Sen, a Kavi Karnapur wrote, this relation never like to speak. It's very bad. Kavi Karnapur wanted to establish the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to speak that time. I don't know. I was just mad. I was so attracted by Krishna Sagar, Krishna Rasa Sagar. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, Kavi Karnapur writing this mood. After taking sannyas, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was exhibiting very nice, sweet craziness and speaking. I don't know my future life. I know nothing about my future life. I am less interested about my future life. I have taken sannyas out of my craziness. Actually, I wanted to jump into the ocean of Krishna Rasa Sagar. Now, without any, consideration, without any judgment, I was bound to jump into the ocean of Krishna Rasa Sagar. Now I don't know. I am going to dip into this ocean or I can swim across. That's up to Krishna. I know nothing. I have no future plan. Sannyas mean no future plan. Who is going to make a 5 years plan in India? Indian government making 5 years plan. 5 years plan. Within this 5 years, we have to do this, 5 years plan. But Mahaprabhu saying, I have no planning, nothing, I am sannyasi, I am mad. I just jump into the ocean of Krishna Rasa Sagar and I am less interested about what will be there in my life in future. What is the future? I am sannyasi. I jump into the ocean of Krishna's life. Krishna knowing what he can keep me or I can get lost, that's up to Krishna. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, I have no trace of prema. I know, in the infinity Brahmanda, Krishna prema is the only property. But I have no prema. No prema ganda osti dvarapi me harau. Tathapi kandami sovhaggavaram prakasitum jad bangsi vilasanam lokanam vina bivarmi prana patanga kanavitha. My life is like an insect. One insect, you know, in front of light, some insects coming, they jump into fire. They cannot stop them from jumping. Because so they are so attracted, you know, some insects, and they're jumping into fire. When fire is glowing, a purpose they jump into fire. If you can say they purposely jumping, who is going to die purposely? It's not right Siddhanta. Who like to jump into fire? To die? Actually not that. This Siddhanta is not good. Actually they cannot resist them from jumping into fire. That is the Siddhanta. Their, you know, fan burnt up. They die. But still, the glamour of this fire, attraction, they cannot check themselves. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking same thing. I cannot check myself. Somehow I is bound to jump into the ocean of Krishna Sagar. Now it's up to Krishna. What will happen, I don't know, in my future, that's up to Him. No prema gandhosti dharapi mehuro. A little bit, no prema. Now you can say, why you are crying? That is a symptom of prema. No! I wanted to exhibit some honor. Tadhapi krandami sauhagga bharam. I like to express my luck. So that someday I can cry. Someday I can cry, so I want to... I am practicing actually. I want to express my luck. That's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Sikkhasa, Nayanam galadasudharaya badanam gadagadarudhaya gira pulakair nichitam bapu kadatavanam gohane bhavishvati. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. When I can get that kind of actual love? When I can get? When I can cry for you? Oh Krishna, oh Krishna. Now it's one kind of dry philosophy in front of you. First of all, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu last 12 years wanted to enter into, you know, Gambira Mandir, exhibiting very secret Leela. But prior to that, before that, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who all the time wanted to do Naam Sankirtan is a means and go. Both. Naam Sankirtan Kalau Param Upai. With Rai Ramananda Mahaprabhu discussing, was same thing Mahaprabhu speaking. Naam Sankirtan Kalau Param. So now I like to discuss some scientific point about Naam Tattva, transcendental sound. Transcendental sound of Prakita Shabda Brahma and Prakita material sound, there is a not heavenly difference, not infinity difference. Actually, we can get from Vedanta Sutya Gaunas chetna atma sabdam. Gaunas chetna atma sabdam. What do you mean by this? Gaunas chetna atma sabdam. Atma sabda. What do you mean by atma sabda? What do you mean by atma sabda? Atma sabda means the sound, and the object it means all same. Sabdo going to identify something, want to speak something, sound, and that object and the sound all non-different. That's why Gaunas Chetna Atma Sabdam, this word. Gaunas Chetna Atma Sabdam. Actually, point is that in Bhagavatam also you can find all the glories of Naam. When Parikshit Maharaj wanted to put some question in front of Sukadev Goswami, Paramahansa Sreshtha, about the highest good, how I can live, how I can get. Atho prichyami saṃsiddhim yoginam param gurum purusa seha yatkaryam mriyamānasya sarvatha. When we know it for sure, we are going to die today, tomorrow, anytime. When we are sure, today, tomorrow, or any time we can die, then we cannot waste our time. We cannot waste our time. So Sarup Goswami, actually Parikshit Maharaj putting question in front of Sukadev Goswami, Atho Prichyami Saṃsiddhim Yoginam Param Gurum. Saṃsiddhi means Siddhi, maybe 18 types of Siddhi, they are ordinary Siddhi. That is not that time of Siddhi. Saṃsiddhi means? Saṃsiddhi means pro, para, apo, anu, saṃ, this kind of if you, upasarga. It's called Sanskrit upasarga, prefix. It's one kind of prefix. If you use this prefix in front of one word, that the volume and the power of the sound increase. Pro, para, apo, anu. In Sanskrit, we learn from that upasargena dhatvartho balad anyatraniyate. What is written about upasarga? Upasarga means prefix. Follow. Upasargena dhatvartho balad anyatraniyate. If you use any prefix in front of this, like I can say pro, one upasarga in Sanskrit, pro. If I say prohar means I can beat you. Prohar, har is there. Prohar, bihar, sanghar. Follow. Prohar, pro, yuktahar. Dhatu. Pro means prefix. If I say pro, then same dhatu. Pro, har. Pro means beating. Pro means I can beat you. Prohar. Or B, if I use B with har, bihar means troubling. You see. Prohar means beating. Or bihar means troubling. Sanghar mean I can take sanghar. Sanghar mean I can finish your life. So this way you see one word, one dhatu. If prefix is there, the word is totally different, total change. So it is written about upasarga, upasargena, dhatvartho, balad anyatraniyate. Forcefully, the meaning of the word is changing. One by one. You have no control. There is so power, dhatvartha. See, follow words. So actually, what Mahaprabhu wanted to say, actually, na prema gandhasthi dvarapi me harau. I have no trace of love for Krishna. Now, Parikshit Maharaj, putting this question, Atho prichyami saṃsiddhim, not siddhi. Saṃsiddhi means sammak siddhi, complete siddhi. There should not be any kind of deficiency. That is the saṃsiddhi. Parikshit Maharaj never wanted to get any kind of normal siddhi. Like 18 kind of siddhi is there. Ashta siddhi and another 10 types of siddhi is there, 18 kind of siddhi. Different kind of siddhi there. But Parikshit Maharaj is less interested about that. Parikshit Maharaj wanted to get siddhi about bhakti. Atho prichyami saṃsiddhim yoginam param gurum purusha seha yat karyam mriyamanasya sarvada. When one jivatma is sure that I am going to die any time, then what is his duty? Mriyamanasya sarvada. anyway, we have to do. That is called bhakti. The same thing Krishna speaking in front of Gopikas in Dasam Skanda, Mai bhaktir hi bhutanam amritutvaya kalpate. Mai bhaktir hi bhutanam amritutvaya kalpate. Amrita, even you can go to Allahabad to take bath in Tribani Sangam, in Kumbh Mela, in Varanasi Kumbh Mela, Kumbh Snan. But we never treat it this way. Our nectar is different, bhakti. Mai bhakti rebhutana amritutvaya kalpate. Also, Parikshit Maharaj putting this question, Shukdev Goswami what speaking? Bhagavad is the topmost document. Because in last of all 800 slokas, what is it in? Naam sankirtanam yasso sarva papa panasanam pranam duksha shamanam tang namami harim param. Last sloka. And in Vedantra? Last? Vedanta last what? Anabriti sabdhyat, anabriti sabdhyat. Double time. Bhagavata end this one. And Vedanta all end, last final conclusion, anavriti sabdhat, anavriti sabdhat. Athat means you go on repeating this name. You exercise, you do on repeating this name. Then you can stop your death and birth. Anavriti sabdhat. Avriti means punarapi jananam, punarapi mananam, punarapi matri jatare sayanam. Shankaracharya speaking, no? Punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam, punarapi matri jathare swayanam. So you can stop this cyclic order of death and birth. And Parikshit Maharaj putting this question, then Sukhdev Goswami giving answer, etat nibrittamananam michyatam makato bhayam. Yogi naam nipanrenitam hare namanu kirtan. What is the excellent gift of Chaitanya? First, and backside this gift, you can get all gift. Follow. That is the focus of the gift. First, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took birth at baby, he wanted to express this Naam Sankirtan. Now I like to put this. Etad nibrittamananam michyatam makuto bhayam. Etad nibrittamananam michyatam makuto bhayam. Those who want to become fearless. Etad nibrittamananam. Nibrittamanam means remedy. Complete solution for whole life. Etad nibrittamananam michyatam makuto bhayam. Those who want like to solve all problems, complete solution, like to get. And those who like to become fearless, for them, it is the suggestion given by all topmost sadhus, big, big sadhus. They all took decision together, one single decision. What is that? Etat nibrittamananam michyatam makutobhayam. Yoginam nipo, hey nipo, oh king. Yoginam nipo nirnitam. All those yogis, yogis mean bhakti yogi, gyan yogi, dhyan yogi, if they are all a neutral platform, they took decision, final decision. What is that? Etat nibrittamananam michyatam akuto bhayam. Yoginam nipo nirnitam hare namanukitanam. They suggest to sing Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Hare Namanu Kirtanam. Hare Namanu Kirtanam mean? Hare Namanu Kirtanam mean? Anu Kirtanam mean? Anu Kirtanam mean? What do you mean by Anu Kirtanam? Hare Namanu Kirtanam repeatedly. And Anu Kirtanam mean under the guidance of Guru Vaishnava. I mean totally you should be inclined. Then Anukirtan is possible. Paramvijayata Sikrishna Sankirtan, okay. But Paramvijayata Sikrishna Sankirtan not applied in my life. If I am 100% inclined unto the lotus feet of my Guru Pad Padma and Prabhupada Bhakti Vinod Thakur, then you cannot stop me speaking Harikatha. Like flood, Harikatha can come. If I am not 100% inclined, I have no right to speak Harikatha. I cannot speak. Param Vijayata Sri Krishna Sangha. That's why Sukhdev Goswami giving answer the same question, what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to prove, the same thing. Etad nibhritamananam michyatam makutubhayam yoginam niponirnitam. They all took decision, Hare Namanu Kirtanam. That is the fine. If you want to become fearless, go out of all problems, you like to make your life flawless and problemless, out of any problem. Now, gaunas chetna atma sabdan tan nishthasya mukhopadeshat Vedanta sutrayana tan nishthasya mukhopadeshat. What do you mean? Tan nishthasya mukhopadeshat. What do you mean? Those who are giving 100% attention to Harinam, tan nishthasya, nishtha mean? Nishtha mean tenacity, attraction for Harinam. You see, fine form, what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is speaking, what Bhagavata is speaking, what Vedanta is speaking, all same. Only we have to reconcile. Tan nishthasya mukhopadeshat. If you like to get moksha, moksha means those who are mayavadi, they moksha, moksha means they like to go out of any problem. They like to go out of any problem. This material was so much problem. No! We never learn this kind of thing. We learn from Kirtan, Tomar Shevai Dukha Hai Yato Sehoto Param Sukh. Tomar Shevai Dukha Hai Yato Sehoto Param Sukh. If I feel so much problem, if I like to do your seva, so many people like to attract me, still okay? Tomar Shabai Dukha Hayato, I've liked to do some seva for you, but so many problems coming in. Well, I can invite all problems. Come, come, come in and invite. We can invite problem. Yes. Yes, Kunti Devi is crying, you're laughing. Kunti Devi. Bipadaho Santuvi. Eh? Kunti Devi praying in front of Prabhu. Prabhu, same different kind of problem in our life. Why? We never heard this kind of thing. Yes, I want problem in my life. If there is problem one by one, then we can find you with me, with us, all the time. Vipadaho santu tattva tattva jagad guru. Anytime any problem happens in our life, we always find you are with us. Eh? Right? All the time. Any problem happen in the life of those Pancha Pandavas, they find Krishna is there. And now you like to put us in a very saturated situation, you are want to give consolation, you stay now, all problem over. I am going to Dwarka. Oh Prabhu, now actual problem now starting. Eh? Actual problem now going to start. Whereas you speaking, problem is over. Kurukshetra battle is over, everything over. Now all problem over, let me go to Dwarka. Prabhu, actual problem now going to start. Eh? What problem? Actually you are going away from us. Then we can be in problem. There's all material affluences. Oh, there can be problem. Actual problem starting now. You say now you are problem free? I'm not problem free? No, actually. That's why we want to be controlled by Guru Vaishnava all the time. We always and every time want to be controlled by Guru Vaishnava. We never like to get control over Guru Vaishnava. No. We want to be controlled. We want to control our life by Guru Vaishnava all the time. That is the main thing. So, from Bhagavatam, we also getting this advice. Nama Sankirtana Kalau Paramupai. Mahaprabhu also speaking in front of Raya Mahasai, Naam Sankirtan Kalu Param Upai. Kisayane Kibhajane Kimba Jagorane Aharni Sichinta Krishna Balahavadhani. All the time go on thinking about Krishna. Bhikkhu Jano Katiloho Kichuna Valai Sukaya Maile Kare Panina Magai Jeija Mangveta Deya Pandhan Gharma Vishti Sahayaner Karai Raksham. Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving very nice mood. Like one tree can bear anything, everything. So you must be more forbearing than a tree. And this is the only Tinada Visunichana Taravasana. That is the only mode. Only qualification, the only qualification. The only qualification. So that you can speak Harikatha and Harikirtan. Tinada Visunichana Taravasana. Avanina Manandino. Kirtaniyo Sadahari. Kirtaniyo, it is the rule to sing Krishna as the glories of Krishna, provided you are established in this point. So, Gaunas Chetnatma Sabdam is over. Now you can understand. Antan Nishthasya Makhyopadeshat. If you have great tenacity for Harinam Sankirtan, Tan Nishthasami, Nam Sankirtanam Jasso. Harinamanu Kirtanam already told. If you have Nishtha, Harinam, you cannot leave Harinam. You cannot leave Harinam. Haridas Thakur, those Javan, those Muslim people took decision to beat him in 12 different markets up to death. The leader of this Javan giving order, he should be beaten to death. I don't want to hear anything. Go. And in 12 different markets, they are beaching Haridas Thakur. Haridas Thakur praying in front of Krishna Prabhu. They don't know what they are doing. They are innocent. Please excuse them. Please excuse them, give them kripa so that they can get bhakti. Now, Haridas Thakur praying in front of Supreme Lord. That is why we have the right to speak. That a Vaishnava, we can find more fear forbearing than a tree. Because a tree can suffer anything, I know. But anyway, a tree cannot pray for me. Can pray? I can cut the tree, I can take flower, I can take leaf, I can, even I can cut the total tree. Tree can bear. But the tree cannot pray for me. Whereas Haridas Thakur can pray for me. Prabhu, please save him. Vaishnavere Abhadane Krishna Dayamaya Ehano Pamarpati Haiven Sadaya. So actually, Haridas Thakur praying for us all. Hey Prabhu, please excuse them. Now, discussion took place between Haridas Thakur and Mahaprabhu about Harinam Sankirtan. Mahaprabhu asking, Haridas, how Muslim people can get read mukti, how they can get? Actually, mokho mean mukti people say, those material people, even Sankar Sampradaya, mukti mean, they like to submerge into impersonal Brahma effulgence. But what is the meaning we get from Bhagavatam, mukti? What we get from Bhagavatam, what is the actual meaning? Muktir hitva annatha rupam sarupena vyavasthiti mukti. From Bhagavatam we get this inner meaning. Muktir hitva annatha rupam. Muktir hitva annatha rupam sarupena vyavasthiti mukti. Sajujyo, sarupo, sasti, salakyo. We are less interested. Muktir hitva annatha rupam sarupena vyavasthiti mukti. If you can discover your sarup, that is called actually mukti. That time you can get bhakti. Bhakti is mukti. Keval, Keval gyan, Keval gyan cannot give mukti without bhakti. Those are gyani, those are yogi. Some sort of bhakti should be compiled. Without bhakti, touch of bhakti, There is yogi, gyani in their respective line cannot get success. Follow what I say. They cannot get success. Yogi, gyani, they all their respective line, they cannot get success until and unless they are in touch of bhakti a little bit. Keval gyan, bhakti bina, dite nare mukti. No, not possible. So, muktir hitva anatharupam, sharupena vyavasthiti iti mukti, tannishthasya mokshopadeshat, mean we can get moksha, we can get bhakti, mukti. Mukti means bhakti. Provided we have tremendous affinity for Harinam. Now, in front of Haridas, Mahaprabhu asking, Haridas, how those Muslim people can get mukti? Haridas Thakur, don't think Prabhu so much about them. Actually, when somehow they are not doing Harinam, but they are sometimes speaking, Haram, 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 they what? They what use? Haram, they is. This they are Haram, they are not actually speaking Harinam, but anyway, out of their, you know, ignorance, anyway, somehow they are speaking Ram. It is not actual Harinam, Namabhas. They are speaking Ha, Ha mean exclamation. Ha Krishna, Ha. They are speaking this way. It is one kind of exclamation, Haram, Haram. They are speaking Haram. But they don't want to speak Haram, not that. But anyway, like Valmiki Muni wanted to speak, yeah, you cannot speak the Nam of Ram. You speak Ram. He cannot speak Ram. Mara, dead body. Mara means dead body. Balmiki says, no Mara, speak Ram. But still cannot speak Mara. He is so sinful activities he has done all his life. Okay. You go on repeating this name, Mara, 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 dead body, dead body. Go on repeating. Hey, go on repeating. Mara, 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 Mara. Mathura, Mothura, Mothura. Mathura means, can churn your, you know, heart. Mathura, Mathura, about, you know, Rasa Bilas, that slok. Tasama Abirabu Chori, Shakshatman Matuman. Sakshatman. Tasam Abirabu Chori, Pitambara Sragvi, Shakshatman Matuman. Manmataman can give a churning and start your mind. Material mind, what to speak about material mind? When Sukhdev Goswami was busy with impersonal Brahma effulgence. Noirgunya nishthito upi. He was having nishtha in noirgunya, nirgun Brahma. But he was attracted with Krishna Nam and Rila. Huh? Parinishthito upi noirgunya. Parinishthito upi noirgunya. He was busy with nirgun Brahma. But ultimately what happens? Nirgunthapi urukrame kurvanti ahitakim bhaktim ittham vato gunaha hari. Ultimately he was bound to run in front of Vyasadev. Speak, speak, speak more, more. I like to hear more. You stay, then I can hear. When the woodcutter came, actually he is a disciple of Vyasadev Goswami. Go there and speak this sloka. Baraha pira natavaravapu karnayo karnikaram. Is sloka. Aho vokiyam stana kalakuran. Two sloka. When speaking, Sukhdeva Goswami breaks his meditation. Who? Where from this sound coming? He looks somebody. Speak more, you come. If you like to speak, hear more, then come. This way, he was caught red-handed. And after that, whole Bhagavatam was kept inside his heart by Vyasadeva Goswami. He was the fittest person, Shuka. A nice parrot. Very nice. That's why you are getting this, you know, sweet Bhagavatam. Rasamalayam muhuraho rasika bhubi bhavuka. We are giving now This way actually, ultimately it was touched by the lips of Sukha Pakhi, Sukha. That's why it's so sweet, Bhagavatam. So, Nairgunya api, Parinishthita api Nairgunya. He was busy with Nirguna Brahma in personal Baba, still was bound to come, run. This way actually. Now you see, this way we find that scientific definition. Actually, when we speak any word, water, horse, tiger, rice, anything, we are having some idea about sound. From child we are learning, this is called rice, this is called horse. Childhood time, there is some picture of horse, one small child, this is called horse, oh really? This way, this is called rice. This way, kindergarten, those small boys. So, from we are out of our own material experience, we having clear idea about what is what. Whenever you say, whenever somebody is speaking rice, we understand, oh, rice. This is called rice. But when somebody is speaking rice, the rice is not there. You are very thirsty. If you are shouting, water, 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 but still water is not there. You are shouting, water, 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 but still, where is water, what is you? You are shouting, speaking water, water, but water cannot come in front of you. Because the word water is different from the object, water. Matter. It's totally different. Follow? It's totally different. But in transcendental world, whenever Madhavendu Purva speaks, Ha Vrindavan, Ha Mathuranath, at the same time, Vrindavan can appear all the time. With his word, Vrindavan. Vrindavan can appear. Follow? That's why Radharani was bound to speak in Kurukshetra, in front of Krishna, Anir Hidai Mon, Mormon Vrindavan, Mone Bone Akkori Mani. Taha Tomar Charanod Doi, Jodi Karao Udoi, Tobe Tomar Purno Kipamani, Bengali. Radharani speaking in front of Krishna. For other people, it is different. They are speaking Vrindavan, but they are not in Vrindavan. Anir Hidai Mon. Some other people, they are speaking something, their heart is there, mind is there, all scattered. Follow? But it's not like that. My life totally different. Rather than speaking in front of Krishna, Anir Hidayamon, what is there in mind, that is there in heart, they are thinking about matter, this, that, but not the case, same case with me. My mind and heart all non-different. And entire heart there is Vrindavan. My mind is equal to Vrindavan. As if Radharani want to speak, I manifest my mind as Vrindavan. Dham. Follow. Anir Hidayamon, Mormon Vrindavan. My mind is equal to Vrindavan. My mind is just equal to Vrindavan. Not that I am speaking Vrindavan, my heart is there. And speaking something, my mind is not there. Anir Hidayamon, Mormon Vrindavan. Mone Mone Akkori Van. Vrindavan and my heart, man, mind and heart, all same. There you will have to go. There you will have to go. If you can go again in Vrindavan and exhibit your Leela, manifest your Leela again with me, then I can think you are full bestow, full kripa on me. You are going to give full kripa on me. Otherwise not. It is the same thing. So, Hare Krishna Mahamantra, it seems, is a Solonam Bhattrijaksho, 16 name and 32 syllable. Solonam Bhattrijaksho, 32 syllable and 16 nam. Also, I like to say, in the meantime, something, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Here this, this meaning given by Jiva Goswami Pad, this meaning given by Gopal Guru Goswami, this meaning of Hare Krishna Mahamantra given by Raghunath Das Goswami, Jiva Goswami Pad. Oh. Anyway, Hare Krishna, first is this Hare Krishna. You do one kirtan, you can remember. You forget. Hari Haraye Nama Krishna Jadavai Nama Jadavai Madhavai Keshavai Nama Gopal Govindaram Simadusudan Giridhari Gopinath Madanamohan. But if I put question, this Hari Haraye Nama Krishna, what do you mean? For so long you are hearing something. If I put this question, what do you mean by Hari Haraye Nama Krishna? Hari directly, okay, Hari. Haraye mean? So many public, so many devotees, they're speaking. Haraye mean mana Mahadev. Hara Hara Mahadev. No! Hara Hara Mahadev. No! It's not Mahadev. They are all speaking wrongly. Hari Haraye Nama Krishna, not Mahadev. Well, no question of Mahadev coming. Where from Mahadev can come? Where from Mahadev can come? Here actually Hari Haraye Nama Krishna. Hari, he Hari, Hari mean? Bhagavan. Who is going to take all evils from me is Hari. I mean that Hari. Haraye mean is Chatutta Vibhi, fourth case ending in Sanskrit. Haraye Namaha. Krishna Namaha. Follow. Muni Muni Munayo Muni Muni Na Muni Bhyam. Ehana. This way. There you can find in fourth case ending. There is Munaye. There is Haraye. I am paying Dandavat to Hari. Hari Haraye Namo Krishna. Jadavainam. Follow. This way. Actually, Hare Krishna mean, there is big explanation, I don't like to go into that matter. Hari mean, who is going to take all evils from me, that is, his name is Hari. Hare Krishna, Krishna mean Krishna, who is doing Leela with Radharani. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. Here, Hare, Hara Sambodhan. When I call somebody, Hare. Hara. And Ram mean, Jiva Goswami was speaking, Raghunath was Ramanath Ram. Ram mean, somebody can think, Ram mean Dasarathi Ram. Is Ramchandra. With bow and arrow. No. Jiva Goswami is speaking, no. Ram Ram Hare Hare. Ram mean, here Ram mean, Ramana, he is playing with Radharani. Raman. Raman mean, playing transcendental pastime is manifesting with Radharani. Ramanath. Ramanath Ram, Ramanath Ram iti uchate. Ramanath Ram iti uchate. Ramana, he is doing Raman. Radha Raman mean? With Radharani, who is doing Raman? Radha Raman. Follow. So, Hare Ram mean actually, Ram mean Ramanath Ram. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving us advice. I already told actually scientific. Ikshetena asabdam. Another Vedanta Sutra. I am bound to speak this. If I cannot speak, it is incomplete. Ikshetena asabdam. Very important scientific Vedanta. Ikshetena asabdam. don't try to look asabda, which is not actually atma sabda. Follow what I say. Ikshetena sabdam, never try to see asabda, which is evil word, material word, which is not actually atma sabda. Follow. Atma sabda mean pure sabda, which is coming from transcendental world. The Vedanta Sutta giving us advice, ikshetena asabdam, never try to see. I mean indirectly this sutra speaking us, indirectly what speaking this sutra? What speaking? Ikshetena asabdam mean try to see, try to look, try to look Aprakrita sabda. Follow? Ikshetana sabda mean don't try to see which is not actually pure sound. Huh? What do you mean? We can see sound? Yes, we can see sound. Indirectly, it is speaking, try to look, try to see sabda. Try to see sabda. So, try to see sabda. Try to see sabda. Try to see aprakita sabda. Is advice? Ikshetana sabda means don't try to see material sound. Material sound also has a shape. Don't say? Material sound, no shape? You can see material sound. Yes, we can see material sound. We can see material sound. There is cardiographic. Your heartbeat, dig, dig, dig. There is curve. Doctor can see. Graph check. Is the shape and design of material sound. You can record anything. The sound vibration frequency can... If you put again, previous, long ago, actually 20, 30 years back, there was gramophone player. There was spin, you see? Recorder, you know, big, big. Huh? Fiesta, big, big. There is, you know, one pin. Recorder is there when it was, sound was recorded. That plate is there, like, you know, big plate. If you put, then it is moving around. Then you put the pin on the track. It's moving and you can hear all song and anything. Follow? 30 years, 40 years back? Eh? That's mean material sound also have some sound design and shape also. So why you cannot believe that Aprakrita Sabda also has some shape and design? Why you cannot believe? We have to believe, 100%. Aprakrita Sabda, the shape and design, that is transcendental. When Madhavendra Purva was speaking, Ha Krishna, Ha Mathuranath, Krishna is present there. With the sound itself, Krishna is non-different. With the sound, Krishna, this Krishna is non-different, Krishna is present there. That is why we can say Bhagavat in the form of Sabda Brahma. Bhagavata, what is Bhagavata? It is written in Shastra. Sukhdev Goswami speaking, Bhagavatam is no other than Krishna. Krishna evahi. Bhagavat, eh? Only some word actually, this compilation of books, what? Transcendental sound. Krishna himself. Bhagavatam is Krishna himself, it is written. So you cannot believe. Krishna se tomar Krishna dite paro, tomaro shakti ache. Why you cannot believe that the diksha of Parikshit Maharaj was done by Sukhdev Goswami while he is speaking Bhagavatam? Through Bhagavatam, Sukhdev Goswami giving Krishna to Parikshit Maharaj. Take Krishna. When Gurudev give you Krishna mantra, Kam Gayatri, Kam Bij, everything, Gurudev giving Krishna to you. Not. Gurudev already giving Krishna to you in fine form. You cannot understand. the day you can come out successful, you can find, oh, excellent thing given by Gurudev. Now you cannot understand. You can remember, I give one example. Long ago, when Chaitanya Math was established, after that, after 5 or 10 years after, some incident happened. Some small devotees, they actually 7 years, 8 years, 10 years, 15 years, all small boys, devotees. They're discussing. They're sitting under a mango tree. They're discussing among themselves. It's called spiritual discourse. I mean, istagasthi. We have one question. What question? Actually, Prabhupada is Nitya Parshad. Our Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Yes, we all agree. Our Prabhupada giving us Harinam. Yes, we are getting Harinam. We have chanting. But we cannot feel anything worse that. Whereas we know Krishna Satamar, Krishna Deva Prabhupada giving us Krishna. Whereas we cannot feel. We are Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare Rama, Rama. We cannot feel. What's that? How possible? Then one senior devotee, later on his name was Bhakti Mayuk Bhagavat Maharaj. Very, very big devotee. He was passing through that class. What discussion going on? No, no, nothing. I say, speak, I like to hear. Also, I can have the chance to enter your istagasthi. No, actually we are discussing Prabhupada eternal prasad. Yes. Prabhupada giving us Harinam. Yes. Why you cannot feel that Harinam is equal to Krishna? Whereas Prabhupada, Krishna said, Krishna already giving Krishna fine form. Yes. Can you speak any reason? Well, I like to speak this. I like to give this answer. You know, they are all godbrothers. They took Harinam. Maybe he is senior. Speaking, actually, point is that whenever one small boy coming in front of anybody, very small boy, if you give some biscuit, lozenge, he become very happy. Happy? If you give some valuable thing like pearl, stone, jewel, or gold, what is this? Useless. 5 years, why? Don't understand. If you are going to give some ornament of gold, what I can do? Huh? Useless. Give me lozenge, give me biscuit. Like Hanumanji Maharaj, when Sita Devi giving some necklace, nice, full of, you know, beautiful, cutting. Hey, what is this? I'm searching, where is my Ishtadev? Sitaram, 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 kahiyo, jai vidhi rakhe ram, tai vidhi rahiyo. Searching, where is Ram? Useless. This way, actually, you are not innocent, you cannot feel it, you cannot feel, now you cannot feel what kind of great treasure Gurudev already, Prabhupada already give you. What? Krishna. No, no, we cannot feel. Krishna Nam is equal to Krishna. You heard? Yes. But we cannot feel. Like a small boy, when he is actually small boys, and father, mother if going to die, then before death, they write all property in the name of that teenager, small. And giving all property under the control of a big company, maybe Talbot company. It is the duty of Talbot company, is the one kind of special company is there. Those who take care of all property, of those who have known or maybe mad, in coma stage or mad, sometime father, mother giving, this full property in his name. Huh? We know one case from England. One very rich man, billions of pounds having. He giving all property in the name of his pet dog. He giving all property in the name of his pet dog. The discussion was going on long ago in my life. Somebody is reading in newspaper, I'm speaking, you see this nice, you know, newspaper, nice news, excellent news. He's saying, what a joke, you see? He writing billions of pounds in the name of his pet dog. Then I was speaking, Nabinji, now I like to speak one important Siddhanta. What Siddhanta? Who is going to write all his property in the name of his pet dog, I don't know what a kind of big dog he is himself. He finds no application of his property. He likes to write all property in the name of his pet dog. In that case, what that dog can do? Actually, somebody has to take control of that. This kind of special company, everywhere, all country, everywhere you can find. Every country, this kind of special company is there. Who going to take care of that property until and unless that boy become 18 years of age, conscious, up to that point he can take control, that company, and in lieu, they can get some salary. Follow? They can get some salary, remuneration. After that, when that boy is 18 years of age, when that boy is already 18 years old, then he give all, you know, property in his name. Now you take control of your property. Now same example given by Bhakti Mayuk Bhagavad Goswami Mahaprabhu. You don't know what kind of property already given by Prabhupada. Now you are innocent. You go on chanting Harinam very carefully and, you know, under the guidance of Prabhupada, Bhakti Mayuk Thakur. Today or tomorrow you can feel Namer Sahite Achen Apanishahari. Name and Krishna are non-different. Tomorrow I like to start with such a sensitive point, it can touch your heart. Today I like to stop here. Vanchakalpudurvushchatkipasindhubhavacho patitanam pavanubhavishnabhyo. Today I can give final touch of Bhuyadamandodaya. What time now? Vyada Mandodaya, this example I can give tomorrow. Today, if any question if you have? Any question if you have? No? I give answer to all questions. See, if there is any question you can put, or I can give final touch to Vyada Mandodaya. What do you mean by Vyada Mandodaya? Daya means kindness. Karuna means mercy. What is the difference? What is the excellency of the Karuna of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? We can discuss tomorrow. Vanchakalpaturushikipasindhubhavcho patitanam pavanabhavishnabhyo.